Bang on them, yeah, in the back, see what that
I'm about to do a reaction video to this this Chrono Rondo end story. First, let me start with this intro. About Chrono Rondo and his friend Timmy with Beaks. Listen to this first verse.
Tell me what's the problem, we can handle that. Hit a pop and leak in, I guarantee they cancel that. Guarantee they cancel that. Quando Rondo, nigga. Leaky told me if you love your nigga, love him to the fullest. Don't put your trust up any bitches, put him in the bullets. I told my brother like this.
Leaky, for those that don't know, he's the dude that killed King Von and the two other dudes.
I like for fame, I could do a hundred.
But, let's go ahead and get to the end of the story. I want y'all to pay attention real good to what I'm about to say throughout this video. I want y'all to go ahead and press like and subscribe to my channel. You know what I'm saying? Help a brother out. Help me build my channel up. Go ahead and press like and subscribe. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to keep dropping. I'm going to keep trying to drop as much as I can. But let's go. You could hear in the beat. I like this beat. It really touch your soul. You already know he about to let his heart spill.
Look, sometimes the best response is none at all. You probably would have left your mans that ain't 100, dawg. See, nowadays it's like the fans doing the police job. Y'all talk that gangster shit, but cry when the nigga get off. You supposed to walk in hell, but shit, I still ain't got my point across. If the shoe was.
The nigga said, I talk that gangster shit, but cry when the nigga get knocked off.
I don't know the foot they want to say they want.
If you're gonna be a gangster, babe, you gotta live by that. You gotta live by that. If you can support that gangster lifestyle, you gotta live with the consequences that come with it.
What they say, that's understood, we had to make it home. I put that on the neighborhood before they bust my dome. Look, Timmy Ryan, right around. Blood on your brother on the ground, gon' pick your mans up. That right, we screaming self-defense, he should've never put his hands on. Look at the foot, that's all the evidence. See them pussy niggas shut the brain up. Who the fuck said that I was hiding? I'm still right around with them bands. And set the records.
So, I'm gonna say this. If you run up to a bunch of Crips, that's suicide for real. Come on, man. Crips, that's one of the most dangerous gangs in America. One of the most violent gangs in America. I grew up running with a whole bunch of Crips. I wasn't a Crip, but all my niggas was Crips. And I know how them niggas move. Them niggas some killers. Them niggas some shooters. They don't play all that action. See, y'all so used to... y'all still used to all these other gangs. These little weak, you know what I'm saying? Y'all forgot, you run up to a gang of Crips, like, dude, you gonna get shot. It's plain and simple.
I ain't never had no show inside the A. Man on my head, that's what they say. That's all you got, bitch, make it A. Come on about.
And one thing about Crips, if you fuck with one, you gotta go against all of them. They all coming at you. Ain't no, nigga, they all coming out busting. That's they gang member. That's they cuz. That's they loke. Nah, they don't play that. Crips don't play that.
Me bite the bag. 30 clip on me, jump out, shake. That shit a shame. I'ma live this way until they put me in my grave. We be on some peace shit. We be on some rock out with that Glock out on some G shit. I be with them youngest, really marked out on that three shit. We be on some block, I blow they block off, hit they street shit. We be on some fucking hitters. My mouth was one of the bitches. What's none at all? You probably would've left your.
You heard the truth in his voice just now, describing him and his young niggas, what they be on. That's true. They really, that's why Chrono Rondo, he spit his lifestyle. They really do that. I'm thinking about back in the day when I was young and I used to run my friends out Crips and watching the activities they got into. Them niggas was some wilds. They was some shooters.
Last that ain't 100, dawg. See, nowadays it's like the fans doing the police job. Y'all talk that gangster shit, but quiet when the nigga get locked. You supposed to walk in hell with shit. I still ain't got my point across. Hey, if the shoe was on the other foot, they wanna say they wrong. Fuck what they say, that's understood. We had to make it home. I put that on the neighborhood before they bust my dome. But tell me why I'm right around. Red rum, top shot at a play, I'm dropping a bomb. Right by the store with all them Crip niggas, only life that I had. What they don't know, he knocked down 40 and did it all with no mask. No many men, they wanna kill me, feeling like Curtis Jackson. Whoa. I don't give a fuck, I know I feel. My man's ain't doing nothing wrong. And if your man's wanna do the same, you need to stop fucking with me. Hear what I say. And everybody take this shit again. I already know it's murder behind this shit.
Sad story. It's sad what happened to between them young men. It's sad what happened to him. Rest in peace, King Von, and free Lil Timmy. Cause I'ma say it like this. Me and my brothers, anybody I roll with, we don't play. So I understand the relationship between Lil Timmy and Quando Rondo. Everybody out here ain't playing. Niggas out here killing. Y'all some young millionaires, man. Y'all some young millionaires and y'all out here killing each other. Y'all out here fighting each other and it ain't even about that, it's bigger than that. It's the end of the story. It's the end of the story. And I ain't talking about the King Von situation. I'm talking about the story called The Children of Adam. Our time on earth. The last day is getting closer. The end of 2020 is getting closer. We are in November. We got another month left until December, until the end of 2020. Throughout that time, it's a lot of things that's been developing. First, I want y'all to go back, for those that missed my video about Halloween and the origin of it, and how they use Halloween to cast spells and stuff, especially this particular Halloween, the 2020 Halloween, where they casted a lot of demons into the earth to that led it up to the election, the distraction election. And a lot of demons been roaming the earth. A lot of magic, a lot of dark black magic, evil eyes has been casted and summoned. A lot of jinns out here. It's a spiritual war. So now what they doing is they turning black man. The black man, young black man, see young black man, those are soldiers. They faster, they stronger. Young men fight wars. That's why they like to start you off when you're about 18, 21. So our young black soldiers out here with all the guns, they are turning their guns against each other. While every other race around the world, every other nation, every other people around the world, they are forming their own armies and their own armed groups to survive what's ever getting ready to happen. Everybody teaming up with themselves, except the black man, the young black man, are killing each other. The spells of demons has been casted in the black neighborhoods. You got a lot of evil witches and a lot of evil warlocks, male witches, which go down and practice witchcraft and magic and all types of Satan jinn worship. And they cast demons into the black neighborhood to make sure they don't progress ever and they stay in this little slum. These are evil people. These are evil. If you worship Satan, you're an evil person. I don't care how much a person smiles, and I don't care how intelligent they sound, and I don't care how many big words and educated and degrees they got. If a person worships Satan, they evil person. And Satan, he's against righteous people. He wants to prevent you from being righteous because he wants you to be dragged into the hellfire with him. Because Satan, he already know where he going. He already know he going on judgment day. He getting thrown to the hellfire. But he wants to make sure he makes sure as many of us, mankind, gets thrown in there with him. So he spent his entire existence on while we on our earth. He's spending his entire time making sure we submit to him, calling us demons, and making sure we make him our friend. We make the demons our friends. We declare to be demons, and that's what King Von was doing. He dropped a song called Demon a couple weeks before he died. He was casting that dark energy. Now he got so many young black men and black girls all around the nation pumping that word into their ears and their headphones and their AirPods, earplugs. They pumping that evil into their heads and they chanting it and it's being in tune with their hearts. The vibration is touching their hearts and touching their spirits, and they're allowing that word demon to open their inner portals up so that real demons that's on the outside waiting could enter their body easily and manipulate them and possess them easily. That's what happens when you cast demonic energy, demonic spells. And the great spell, the great witch holiday, which was October 31st, Halloween, that half of y'all sent y'all kids out to go play with the demons that come out on Halloween sunset and roam the earth. And y'all kids out here trick-or-treating, going to all these witches' houses, getting candy from these witches' houses and bringing it back to y'all, bringing it back home. And everybody participating in these demon-possessed houses for fun called haunted houses. Every single year, you're building up more and more evil upon your land, upon your people, upon your children, upon yourselves. So with that being said, the other day, a few days ago, they had Young Jeezy versus, with all the demons that's been roaming the earth since Halloween, the extra demons, the extra spiritual spells that's been casted, and their new elections, who's going to sit on the throne of Satan, which is the White House for the next 4 years. You know, that whole clown circus show. I hope y'all ain't partaking in a vote, man. Just sit back and watch the demise of Babylon. I want y'all to pay attention to this video, press like, and you know what I'm saying, and subscribe to my channel, because I'm about to get into it, inshallah. So anyways, they had a versus battle, Young Jeezy versus Gucci Mane. That's more war. It's conditioning the mind of the black man to go to war with another black man, to show his violence towards his own brother. Even though they did squash it, but still, man, that's still... That's still energy they putting out into the universe. For what? The culture? The culture of what? The culture of sin? The culture of Satan? The culture of evil? The culture of killing? The culture of drugs? The culture of fornication and prostitution and pimping? The culture of shooting and murder? What culture? It's surely not the culture that was prescribed to our ancestors, which is in the Torah, to be holy, righteous people, obedient to the laws and commandments of the Most High God, who we have to face as soon as we die. And one of his commandments is thou shalt not murder. Y'all out here murdering, like y'all don't care. Y'all said. Y'all turned your backs on God, huh? You just turned your back on God, huh? Especially you, those who claim to worship the Most High God, those who claim to worship Allah, those who claim to worship Yah, those who claim to worship the creator of the heavens and the earth and the universe and all in between. You should know full well that you shouldn't be condoning or promoting murder unless it's for self-defense against an invading nation that's trying to invade your land. Then you fight back. Then you defend your home from somebody trying to impose physical harm or murder you. But if you're out here murdering over unjust, unholy, sinful reasons, don't you know that once you die, and if you're not forgiven, don't you know the hellfire awaits you? Oh, I know. You don't believe in all that. Man, you ain't taking that serious, man. Man, that's a fairy tale, man. That's a myth, man. That's made up. The white man made that up to control you. I know. I heard all the lies and excuses and the reasons y'all made up in your own heads to deceive yourself into disbelieving in the existence of the hellfire, a place that God Almighty has created for people that reject him and disobey him and that do wicked upon this earth. And that follow in the footsteps of Shaitan, the demon, the chief demon. Why is a person calling themselves a demon, knowing the demon is a servant of Shaitan, of the devil? Why do a person want to call themselves a servant of the devil? You see where we are in the year 2020, the end times for those that got 2020 spiritual vision. Y'all see where we at? Y'all see what's going on? Pay attention. So here we are at the end of the 2020, and Quando Rondo dropped a song called End of Story. It's bigger than that. We're coming to the end. We're coming to the end of Babylon's oppression and rulership over the children of slaves, which is us black folks in America who descend from slaves, and Native Americans. And Latinos in the Caribbean, and Puerto Rico, and Cuba, and Dominica, and Haiti, and Jamaica, all the descendants of slaves. We are the same people. We cousins. We different tribes from the same. You know what I'm saying? Y'all fathers are uncles. And they all had the same father. His name was Jacob, or Yaqub. Later in his life, his name was changed to Israel. We are the children of Israel. We are the descendants of slaves. Israel is a prince. He's a prince chosen from the Most High God Almighty. He chose him and his children to inherit his covenant. What is the covenant? Obey these laws that he gave us in the Old Testament, the Torah, the Tanakh, the laws given to Moses. Obey these laws and you will rule the earth. Disobey them, you will be the slaves of the earth. What did our ancestors eventually doing? At first we started off as kings and princes of Israel. But then our hard-head ancestors, you always got some knucklehead Negroes that don't want to listen. I want to ruin it for everybody else. And I want to be a demon, a savage and stuff. While everybody else trying to be righteous and make it into the kingdom of the Most High and make it into paradise. We always got that one grimy group of people that just don't give a F. And they drag everybody else down. And our ancestors started breaking the laws of the Most High. They started breaking the laws. And guess what? The Most High said, oh, okay, watch this. Hey, Mr. White Man, go over there in West Africa where they hiding at. And take them over to America and the Caribbeans and South America and whip them. This is prophesied to happen in the book of Deuteronomy 28, the curses. Read that when you get a chance if you never read it before. A lot of people already know about it, and it's no secret no more because the truth is being revealed. So, also, while all this is happening, while everybody is preparing for World War III or Civil War or whatever war, all these wars and rumors of wars, which is the precursor of the return of the Messiah, the son of Mary, we got all this chaos happening, but the black man is at, the young black man in the inner cities are at war with each other, while the rest of the world is preparing to go to war with you again. The rest of the world is preparing to militarize themselves to make sure that you black man gets the vaccine first. Mandatory. And y'all out here being distracted and being taught by the evil television and media the evil music industry, Hollywood, the Illuminati, all that evil crazy stuff, the whole entire synagogue of Satan. Y'all out here being taught to be evil, wicked men that's killing each other and that spend your entire lives sinning and turning your back against the Most High. And now you're at the bottom and the target is on you. The target is on your black woman. The target is on your black children. They need you, black man. They need you to be a warrior of the Most High. They need you to be disciplined. They need you to be separate away from the ways of Babylon. They need you to man up and learn how to be a man of God, a man of the Most High, to be a servant of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever you claim to be, whether you're Jew, Christian, Hebrew, Israelite, Muslim. We all worship the same creator. There's only one creator that created the heavens and the earth and Adam. Whoever created Adam, that's who we all worship. Because there's only one creator of Adam. And don't everybody believe in the story of Adam. The disbelievers, they are lost and misguided. Wandering in the darkness, thinking they see light. Every time they see lightning, flash of lightning in the darkness, they go towards it. They take a step towards it, thinking they found something. But they still in darkness once that lightning disappears. Waiting for another lightning bolt to show them a false light, thinking they got light, thinking they woke and activated in their mind, but really they still in darkness. They still in a dark thunderstorm. Look at that as an example. Chapter 2 of the Holy Quran. real person with real knowledge and real light, real activation of everything. Both their eyes, they could see out of inner pineal gland, because they connect their pineal gland down to the earth when they prostrate before the Most High and praise Him and glorify Him. Subhanahu Rabbi Allah, all glory be to the Most High. All glory be to my Lord, the Most High. All glory be to the Lord, the Most High. When you see me bowing down, connecting my forehead to the ground before the foot, before the throne of the Most High, and praising Him and glorifying Him, I'm activating my spirit. I'm activating my body. I'm activating my pineal gland. That's true light. There's no better light than the light from the Most High, where there's no darkness. It's nothing but truth, clear and evident for all to see that really believe. But we're living in a time where the spiritual war on the black man has been raging ferociously. And most black men, they have been left unprotected from the attacks of the Shayateen and those that serve him. There's an entire race of people on this earth that serve the Shayateen, that serve Shaitan, Satan, devil, Lucifer, Iblis, the dragon, evil, the prince of darkness, Samhain. That's what we gotta realize. You gotta pay attention to the spirits, baby, the energy, the unseen world. When I pray to the Most High, I pray for angels. I don't claim demon time. I claim angel time. I claim the Most High God's time. That's my protector. That's who I'm going to turn to. That's who I'm going to pray to. You got beef for me, I'm going to pray to the Most High that He get rid of that beef for me. And it has worked plenty of times. I done prayed to the Most High. I done beefed with niggas before. And I ain't even do nothing to him. I just made a prayer. A couple years later, a couple months later, I hear about something happened to him. I don't pray for their death, but if that's the only way that the Most High could solve the beef, when I pray to Allah, I pray. If I'm in any kind of situation, I pray that He solves it for me. He removes that obstacle out of my life for me. That's my protector. I'm going to turn to God. Who's a better protector than God? Who's a better hero than God? Who's a better helper than God? Huh? For those that believe. So anyways, you got Gucci Man and Young Jeezy. They pumped that energy of beef between black men out into the universe, especially into the inner streets where it's gonna get hit the hardest, because they're more influenced by the kind of demonic energy down there, and due to all the evil witches from the suburbs that go down there and cast their spells late at night and do all kind of summon up all kind of evil djinns to terrorize the neighborhood spiritually, to keep them cursed and demonically possessed spiritually. That's why at nighttime you go in the hood, you're gonna see a demonically possessed person walking through. You probably gonna look at them as a drunk or a drug head. No, drugs and alcohol, that is opening portals to demons. They said the night King Von died, he was drunk, meaning he was possessed by a demon. He told us in a song before he died about the demons in his life. And You know what a demon does? A demon enters your body. You know what your body is to that demon? Your body becomes a car, and the demon's evil. A demon so grimy, if you give the demon the wheels to your car, the demon gonna crash your car just so you could die. The demon know he ain't gonna die. He know right before he crashed into that wall of that car, he gonna flee about your body, and now you down there messed up, and the demon off somewhere laughing, looking at you all twisted up and dead. That's how you shouldn't drink, because when you drink, that's why you feel relaxed when you drink, when you get drunk. I ain't never got drunk before because I don't drink. I ain't never drunk before. I don't know how it is, but I've been around people that got drunk before, and I look at them, and I try to study their state and their condition, and I realize that alcohol opens up a portal inside their body. It's a chemical that opens up a portal inside their body, that and other kind of drugs and intoxicants that opens up portals in your mind and your body, allowing demonic genes to enter your body. And the more you drink, the bigger the portal becomes, and the more powerful the gin is entering your body, because it's lowering your vibration, your frequency. Now you ain't got no shield around you protecting you, because your vibration that gives off this invisible force field, your vibration is low. You have a low frequency. Now the gin is controlling your body. And guess what the gin wants to do? It becomes violent. It wants to fight people. That's why a lot of people go to bars, they get into bar fights. They become violent. It's not them, it's the violent gin. The gin wants something to happen to you. They want you to die. That's why a lot of people get behind cars driving. They get into car accidents because It's not because they drunk. It's because it's a demon that's driving their body, and the demon's mind. The demon want to crash into that pole. The demon want to crash into the car. The demon want to have fun and swerve off, while you slump back in the sunken place when you drunk. And then the demon drive your body, and then when you wake up out that sunken place, you like, damn, I'm in the hospital. Damn, I'm behind bars for fighting. Oh, damn, what happened? I got raped. If you're a female, you don't know what happened. When you get drunk, females, the sex demons enter you, and that's why you be around certain men with sex demons. Also, them demons gonna have sex while y'all drunk, and you passed out, and you don't know what happened. That's why dudes use drugs. Drugs is a witchcraft magic potion that opens up portals. I ain't gonna get into all that right now, but y'all get the drift. But if I was little Tim and I seen a crowd niggas, Chirac niggas, savages from O Block approaching my nigga, I already know what kind of reputation these O Block Chicago niggas got, these savages got, these Southside Chirac niggas got. I already know what kind of reputation they got. I know they some killers, but guess what?